Welcome back, everybody. High Tech Lab here. In today's video, we have some 4-aught battery cable, and these two pieces I've already cut to length. These are going to go up here on my Sol Arc inverter and tie onto my bus bars. But either way, in today's video, we're going to be showing you how to crimp the lugs on here. Let's get started. First thing, tools you'll need. I have some cutters. This is what I use to cut the battery cable. This is just a set of Klein cutters. You'll need a Sharpie, some scissors if you're putting heat shrink on. I have my lugs in here, obviously. You're going to need a tape measure. It doesn't need to be any specific length, but just one you can measure with. This is my bulk heat shrink. And this right here is the most important tool. This is a hydraulic crimping tool. Now, I got this in a kit on Amazon. It was about 50 bucks, if memory serves correctly, and definitely worth the money. Now, we're going to crimp these cables, and later in the video, we're actually going to cut through one of the crimps and see how well this tool actually is doing. So if you're interested in buying a battery crimper, I'll throw the link in the description after we see how well this does. Other than that, I have a knife that's nice and sharp, and this is what I'm going to be using to cut through the insulation. Okay, so the first thing we're going to want to do is take our tape measure and measure how far we need to strip back our insulation. So in this case, the lug starts tapering down after about 1 inch of depth. So we're going to strip back 1 inch of insulation on this wire. So I'm going to take my tape measure and my Sharpie, and 1 inch back, I'm going to make a mark. So now, one trick I learned in the electrical apprenticeship is you could take your wire cutters and go on your mark and give it a spin. Now, you don't want to squeeze super tight because then you can nick the wires inside. You're just trying to make a score, essentially. And that score is where you're now going to take your razor knife and follow that score. That way you can strip around the wire in a perfect circle. Now, you don't want to press too hard because this super fine strand wire could possibly get cut. You're just trying to get the most of the way through. And then in this step where I bend it, if there's anything still connected, it'll come the rest of the way through and you get your insulation off. So now that that's done, I can take my lug and I can be very careful and make sure I have all the strands in there. And it should go on there just like that. At this point, we're ready to make the crimp. So at this point, I'm gonna take a second. I've already done one lug just to spare us some time. We're gonna imagine that's gonna go on the positive terminal of our inverter. Now, what I'm trying to get at here is down here, once it goes through the grommet hole, I'm gonna want that lug at that angle. So essentially, these lugs twist, and I wanna make sure that this isn't like 180 degrees out, and then I'm trying to bend the cable and twist it because this stiff 4-aught cable doesn't twist the easiest. So I've got that pretty much on the same rotation as the first lug, and now I can crimp on the second lug, and we'll show you how to do that now. Okay, so here on my hydraulic crimping tool, I have the correct die installed. In this case, it's stamp 95 for this 4-aught cable. This is in millimeters square, I believe, but there's a conversion chart, and it crosses over to 4-aught. So I'm going to spread these lugs out. And by the way, if your tool is not already, you're gonna wanna loosen it up by turning it to off and then close it back up so that now the dies are spread apart. And now that I have my orientation correctly on my lug, I can go ahead and install that in there and begin pumping the tool. And I'm just trying to get the tool close to where it needs to be. I don't want to actually start crimping yet. So right here is where there's kind of some pressure, but I can adjust this if I want. Now on my crimps, I like the top and bottom to be flat. So this is the first crimp I will do. Once it's lined up exactly where I want it, I could go ahead and crimp this. And I'm going to go until these dies touch. Essentially, that gap in there will be gone. And once that's gone, I can release the tool. And there I have my first crimp on there. But on these lugs, I like to go a little bit more. So I'm gonna scoot down a little bit and give it one more crimp. Now, some of the cheaper tools, you can't do this. You typically need to do one crimp and then turn this a sixth of a turn because you'll get little parts on the side that squish out. But with this tool, it does it pretty good, so I don't need to worry about doing that. So now with the relief valve on the crimper closed, I'm going to pump it one more time and get that second crimp on there. Okay, so we've got that second crimp done. You can see the first one ended at about that line right there. And the second one's on there. So this is nice and tight. Now, I'm not going to be able to pull this off because it's fully crimped correctly. But always give it a good tug test and make sure everything's right. If for any reason yours comes out of the lug, then you've done something wrong and you need to redo your crimp, quite possibly adjusting your dies. So now I'm going to take the heat shrink. And this isn't exactly critical, but I'm going to cut off probably about 3 inches, 3.5 inches, somewhere in there. And now I can slide that over the end like that. And now I have a heat gun here and I can shrink this onto this lug. Now this heat gun has a really nice tip that's a really wide angle. Normally you would either want a wide angle piece or to move a lot. You really don't want to heat up one spot too much. So now that this side is mostly shrank, I'm going to flip it around and do the other side. And there we go. So now you're ready to go. Now this is going to be hot from the heat gun. Don't touch it yet because you'll leave a nice fingerprint. But yeah, this cable is ready to go and ready for me to install. And I'm just going to repeat the same process for the other cable. Now, I did just show you the first lug, but you're just going to repeat that same thing for the second lug. And by now, you're probably a professional, so you're good to go. So I'm not totally certain on these lugs as to the quality of the crimp. So we have our lug here crimped how I think we're supposed to. And right here behind me is my Evo Evolution chop saw. This is designed to cut metal. It's got a 15-inch carbide blade. I forget the tooth count, but I think it's normally like an 80 tooth or something like that. It's pretty fine. And this will cut right through steel, stainless steel, anything. So this soft copper is nothing for it. So we're gonna get this in here and tighten down, and we'll go ahead and cut through that and see how well it did. Okay, so I'm going to get it right about in the center of the crimp and tighten that down nice and tight. And let's go ahead and cut through this. So, all right, let's check it out. So the nice part about this saw is it's nice and cold. So if I touch this, there's no issue there. And actually, we'll put a close-up picture on the video, but this literally looks like solid copper in here. It's definitely nice and tight. So I'm definitely impressed with that, and I feel like I am getting a good crimp on that. And actually, if I touch this with my finger, it actually feels nice and smooth, and that's because this saw makes such a nice, clean cut. And if we look at the other side, yeah, I mean, these are really nice and smooth. So now, curiosity as always, I've got down here some 500 MCM cable, and this I didn't build, but this label on it from the previous application says return battery room terminal bar. And this, like I said, 500 MCM or Kesamil, and I want to cut through this lug and see how that compares to the other one. Now, if it weren't for this video, I wouldn't want to do this, because typically these lugs cost about $200 a piece, but this is High Tech Lab and we have access to this stuff and it pretty much cost us nothing. So let's cut through this and see what's inside. So what's impressive here is this lug actually has air gaps on the side. And we'll put a close-up on the screen now, but this is definitely not as smooth as the last one. The strands aren't quite compacted as tight. So now seeing this that was totally professionally crimped, I feel confident about how our lugs are coming out. And it's definitely nice being able to take a cross-section of this and see just how well they came out. If you guys have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And if you're not sure what you're doing, it's better to seek the advice of a professional than to have a bad crimp. This cable, for example, will have a couple hundred amps going through it. And if this were loose and started heating up, you can have severe risk of fire, that kind of thing. All that good stuff. So anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this video and learned something, leave a thumbs up. If you want to learn more about solar batteries and off-grid, be sure to subscribe to the channel. Other than that, I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks. Bye.